Every great idea has a humble beginning. The seed which had been sown 10 years ago has now grown into a tree that branches to all departments of our faculty. But it has not always been so.
It was a very big faculty because it's made up of a lot of different subjects. And so it was very difficult to get everyone back together to form one faculty, which is what in fact it is.
You know, she wanted to organize something. Actually, I think she said something like, I have an idea. And whenever Debbie says, I have an idea, that usually means that I'm going to have to be doing a lot of work to make that idea happen. So essentially, this idea started taking shape, and I felt I was part of something that was being born. So it was only natural to join the executive because I was one of the people that was helping to create this new organization. But it was good fun.
The stone has been set, and the group of enthusiastic individuals set forth in creating a society that would represent not just themselves, but all the students in their faculty.
We spoke to each student, we disturbed quite a few lectures, and we also put up posters. We had a series of 5 posters, which all had the tagline, wanna be part of it? We got somebody to design the posters for us, and they all had a slightly different message, but the overall message was, do you want to be part of this new organization that was exciting, that was new, that was young? But we also went individually to each individual class to encourage people to join, and it worked.
Because we were 5 from biology and chemistry waiting there in the room thinking that no one else would come. And then we see this guy coming in with his umbrella. Hi, it's Matthew, he said, and we all started laughing. And then more people came in and it was as if it was going to happen.
And happen it did. Despite the many struggles and challenges that were faced, S-Cubed was formed.
S-Cubed, if I remember rightly, I think I was in the faculty board meeting that decided to support the birth of S-Cubed, because I think we had the University Science Students Association before that. And that went defunct and S-Cubed was born.
Throughout this decade, S-Cubed has sought unity amongst science students by organizing various educational and informal activities to provide a holistic experience for each and every one of us.
I think considering the fact that at university, the courses are very theoretical, and they are very focused on the scientific aspect in the case of our courses. I think there are some skills which you still need within a couple of years once you leave university at work, which you can gain from these organizations. And I think S-Cubed gave me the opportunity to enhance my organizational skills, my managerial skills, the teamwork that you work in teams, communication skills, especially when promoting events, when speaking with people, when convincing with people, when sitting down on a board table with different stakeholders to make the points, the problems that students face. I think these are all skills which at the end of the day, you'll find them valuable at work and also in your life later on.
What I learned from S-Cubed was that you have to consider other things in life apart from the course and the academic part of your stay at university. And you have to get to know people, meet new people, like get involved in organizing events, attending events, something which most students lack in my opinion.
Student participation is at the heart of S-Cubed, for it is us students who made it what it is today. It is with the prospect of a new student generation that we seek to make our society strive even more to create a friendly, welcoming environment.
I would describe S-Cubed as fun, educational, and helpful.
I would describe it as informative, hard working since a lot of work has to be done before creating such events and fun.
It allows informal learning during the many activities, and it allows you to meet other students in your faculty.
S-Cubed endeavors to achieve better interaction between science students. Events are a way for us to get together and to get to know each other better.
Our favorite event is the annual seminar because it allows us to learn about new science subjects during talks and meet other people at parties.
Certain activities are hard to forget, and when you are the one faced with unplanned situations, stress can take over.
Well, one particular experience which will clearly stick in my mind is when we went to Switzerland last year. It was a really awesome trip. We went to CERN and a few other places which were really quite mind-blowing throughout the trip. However, one moment which really sticks in my mind is when we were waiting for the transport to take us to the salt mines in Bex. And the transport never really came. At that moment, I had to deal with people who are unhappy because they were waiting with their bags packed, just about to leave towards the salt mines. People who were fighting because they were throwing balls at each other. People who are unhappy because they hadn't eaten yet. And Michael, who was trying to phone from Zurich, from Geneva, at the grand price of 50 euros for a few calls. Just to get the transport to get there. That was a very stressful day, but all in all, it worked out.
However, we also cannot forget the fun parts.
At one point, we organized a party themed Miami Vice, and we were actually looking for some props, and we came with an idea of actually put up some palm trees. So we went all around Malta with a car, looking up for palm trees and actually pulling up palms so that we can actually decorate the party.
Education is not just about studying, research, and stressful long nights getting your reports done. It is also about involving oneself in order to gain a deeper educational meaning.
The social side cannot be underestimated, I think, because students will tend to want to be part of a group, and I think S-Cubed provides that.
And when I came back to Malta, I saw a big change from when I was a student, which is longer than it might appear. The students had come together, as I saw it, and they were organizing wine nights, exhibitions, seminars, and I was really pleased to see that, the students had actually started to come together, and it not just being come here, learn, go back home, study. It's a matter of you come to university and you make new friends that can last the rest of your life, as some of the friends I still have are. And I think that is really important for an education.
With the recent addition of innovative ways to keep in touch with students, like the annual science gathering and share it, S-Cubed has provided us with an opportunity to express our knowledge base and work together in becoming better students and better scientists.
S-Cubed, as you know, organizes lectures, it organizes talks by students, which is an excellent idea because students now have a chance to have a go at public speaking in front of other students, and that is a very important learning experience. Speaking in front of an audience, speaking in public, speaking in front of people, is a skill that scientists must learn, and S-Cubed is providing students with those opportunities.
You have been responsible for the excellent magazine In Touch, which is really very professionally put together. And this is not just my opinion, but also the opinion of specialists in science communication. I also noticed with great pleasure the video tutorials that are coming up. These are meant to explain laboratory techniques and other techniques that are very helpful to students. Then there is, of course, the annual social event that has been now entrenched in the traditions of this faculty, which is the annual science gathering, which I really support.
The past 10 years have been an amazing journey for ESCUBED. Through thick and thin, science students have built and maintained a family which has sprouted many friendships and bolstered our education.
I hope that ESCUBED remains a very active student organization like it has been in the past few years, and probably it will be in the future as well, defending student rights, organizing activities, and giving out opportunities, helping students to get around with their career in the science field.
The stage is now set for the next torchbearers to run the marathon and for ESCUBED to sprint forward towards new beginnings. The next decade shall be even more exciting. All we have to do is make it happen.
Well, in the next 10 years, ESCUBED will go wherever the students want to go. Ultimately, as we all know, the students are what makes ESCUBED. They're the lifeblood of ESCUBED. Indeed, the very essence, the being of ESCUBED. And as such, whatever students want to do, then ESCUBED will do.